I went to school till I was 14. Then you left to go to work. And the employment was hard to get for everybody then. In fact, I went back to school for another 6 months, I think, before I even got a job at Maynards. I used to walk all the way to work up the Welbeck Road, down at by the what we call the village where the biker wall is now, round that part of that, round there, down Avondale Road, a big hill, along St Michael's Road, down Albion Road, across the last. Took me half an hour to walk to work every day. I used to get a variety of jobs. Sometimes you're pushed in the warehouse for orders. There had a lot of, well, there was all kinds of things, yeah, mostly hand wrapping. But I was there, I think, a couple of years. I was on the first machine they got to wrap them. Feed them in and wrapping them, you know, instead of just sitting wrapping them.
Uh-huh.
Got that then. Got a job. I was once labelling the bottles. I must have had a street. I was sticking the labels on the bottles. Awesome. But you got a variety of different ones, you know, thing. But you worked from 7:30 in the morning, an hour off at dinner time, till 5 o'clock at night. And you worked Saturday morning as well. 48-hour week you had then. My first wage was 10 shillings and sixpence, what I got then. And actually, they were always very busy in the summer, but in the winter, the orders dropped off because they didn't have the seaside places and that, you know, for the shops. And usually were suspended sometimes in the winter. But on the whole, they sent back for you after they got a bit busier, you know. And, well, in the summer it was busier than the winter, of course, as a lot of them sort of finished. Maybe about 30, I think, something around there. The boiler room and then the warehouse girls and the packing room. And there's a woman on the washing bottles, poor old soul. Yeah, I used to feel sorry for her. Washing bottles all day. She had a great big deep sink. She used to was washing all those bottles. I remember her. But they had a sort of canteen. But you had to take your own lunch with you, you know, and whatnot. You could make a cup of tea again, but nothing like they have today. And if you weren't very good, sometimes, you know, usual times, the forewoman, she used to give us a teaspoonful of brandy and hot water. A teaspoonful, you know.
If you weren't well on the job, she'd send you home.
You didn't get stopped work, you didn't get sent home, mind you, had to struggle on. Oh, dear. I was married the year the war started, 1939, mm. And you didn't have a party or anything when you left, you know, nothing like that. You all came down for tea one day, you see, about 5 or 6. The ones you worked with, more or less, you see. But I worked till I was 24, till I left to get married. And in those days, you never thought of going back to work. That's what you got married for, to look after your husband.